great kindness, compassionate love, more meaningful than loving kindness, more religious, compassionate love. Because loving kindness also, there is some sort of link with emotional or some sort of attachment, loving kindness. When you say compassionate love, completely free from all the bondages and attachments, because I choose from here and there which are useful for you. Three stanzas together. Right? Attham hi jatam hi sukha sahaya. Sukhaya itari tarena punyang sukhang jivita sankhayang hi sabbassa dukkhassa sukhang pahanang. Sukhamatteyata loke ato petteyata sukha. Sukham yāva javā sīlaṁ sukha saddhā patitthitā. Sukho puñyassa paṭilābho pāpānaṁ akaraṇaṁ sukhaṁ. Attham hi jātam hi sukha sahāyā tutti sukhāyā itari tarena puñyaṁ sukhaṁ jīvita saṅkhayaṁ hi sabbassa dukkhassa sukhaṁ pahānaṁ sukhamatteyata loke sukho petteyata sukha sukha kāmanyata loke atho kāmanyata sukha sukhaṁ yāva jarā sīlaṁ sukha saddhā patitthitā sukho puñyassa paṭilābho pāpānaṁ akaraṇaṁ sukhaṁ. Three stanzas together, all are interrelated. Meaning, when need arises, person is to be, have friends. Person is, it is to be content with just this and that. Person is merit when life is at an end. Person is the shunning of all ill. So this word you can understand very easily, sukha. Same meaning. Attham hi jatam hi sukha sahaya. Whenever we have some work, whenever we need others' support, at least moral support, whenever we are in trouble or we are sick, at that time we feel the importance of friends. Why friends are important? Real friends come to assist us, give their support, moral support, reduce our fear and tensions and worries, to console us in various ways. That is why it is mentioned in another place, Vishasa Paramanyati, in the sayings of the Buddha. The reliable or trustworthy friends are the real relatives. Not because that we had some blood relationship with others. Those who have some blood relationship claim something. They say, we are bound to do something for them because of that blood relationship. If not, they can accuse or blame. But friends are not like that. The Buddha says, Vishasa, reliable, trustworthy. Friends are the real relatives. Because without any blood relationship, they come to give their support, give their helping hand, when their services are needed or when we are in trouble. So friends are very important. In Mangala Sutta also, the Buddha mentioned, those who have good friends, who develop their understanding, mutual understanding, are blessed. They are very fortunate. Because there are many things that they can do for their friends to release their worries and fear and suffering, to give them some sort of confidence, especially when they are very sick. At that time, we need their support. Because there are many things that they can do for us, to console us when we have frustrations or unsatisfaction, disappointment. They can give us confidence. Therefore here the Buddha says, attham hi jatam hi sukha sahaya. So when we need some services, then we feel the importance of friends. The next line, tutti sukhaya itari tarena. This one we always discuss. One who is contented always experience sukha. No worries, no jealousy, no anger, no enemies, no problems, no troubles, no violence, because they are contented. So when we are contented, we can avoid so many problems. It is due to
your nose.
Contentment is one of the greatest achievement. Santutti paramang dhana. Here the Buddha says, santutti, contentment or satisfaction. Paramang, highest. Dhanam, wealth. Highest wealth is a contentment, not the property. Property cannot give contentment. Property develop fear, worries, suspicion, uncertainty, insecurity, jealousy, anger, enemies, so many problems. But one who is contented, that contentment he take as wealth. Because of that wealth, he experienced security, happiness, satisfaction, and peace. So by reducing our crazy attitude towards so many things, the more we become humble or simple, the more we experience happiness in our life. But the trouble is, we are going on adding more and more gadgets in our life, in our dress, in our food, in our enjoyment. We are going on increasing, increasing, increasing. And now we do not know where we are. We cannot go down. We cannot slow down. Because we were caught. And then we struggle. The problems, disturbances come to us because of this extra gadget that we increase. I think you can remember I have told you a Muslim scholar what he has said about 100 years ago. In Urdu language he has written a beautiful poem. He says, if you want to see the most contented, the happiest man in this world, look at that prince who is in beggar's clothing, referring to the Buddha. He is a prince but wearing a beggar's clothing, but the most contented and happy human beings on this earth. Now this clearly shows, the more we become humble and simple, we increase the values in our life. Human values we can see there, not in our dress. There is no human values in our dress. The more we become simple, then we increase the values. So by considering this very carefully, in various discourses, the Buddha has mentioned this, santutti paramang dana. Try to maintain contentment as much as possible. Then people ask, if we maintain some sort of contentment, thinking this is enough, there is no development. And what sort of development do they expect? If there is no happiness, if there is no security, if there is no safety, if there is no freedom, what sort of development they can gain by developing their greed and selfishness? They never gain any satisfaction. Invite more trouble, more headache, more problems. Then, the more we become humble, then nobody want to disturb us. Nobody want to criticize or condemn or accuse or blame. And no jealousy, no anger. We will be free from all these things if we can reduce too much of crazy attitude toward the pleasure as well as toward the way of life. Otherwise there is no end. It's a very big battle. We will be free from this battle if we can maintain this contentment. Contentment does not mean that you should not work. You had to work, you had to earn, you had to work very hard. But after gaining what you needed for you and for your family to maintain, to sustain everything, that is called contentment. Now this is enough. We don't want to go beyond that. That is called contentment. So that is the second sukha. Here, according to this, tutti sukhaya itari tarena. Punyang sukhang jivitang sankayampi. Punya is the real happiness that gives us confidence. Our property cannot give us confidence. Uncertain. Property can be destroyed by fire, flood, or thieves, if not bluffing, cheating, stealing, uncertain. Or government also can confiscate anytime, uncertain. But punyang sukhang jivitang rak. For a life most reliable, unchangeable, property or sukha or the happiness is our own good karma. Punya means our own good karma. This good karma, this punya, no one can destroy. God also cannot destroy. The Buddha also cannot destroy. Devils also cannot destroy. No one can steal. There is nobody in this world who can destroy your good karma. And also bad karmas. No one can destroy. But you can destroy if you know the technique. Others cannot do that. So if you know that you have accumulated, you have performed enough punya, enough merit for you to maintain your life within this lifetime, especially hereafter. Because within this lifetime, we are spending what we have earned, accumulated during the previous birth. Spending. So while spending the good merits, we are also going on accumulating fresh karma. Just like your bank account. What you have deposited, you withdraw. After that, you go and deposit some more. It's exactly like this. So you should not waste all your good karmas that you have accumulated during your previous birth without accumulating fresh karma for your future. Because there is nobody else to take the responsibility of your life. Remember that. You cannot depend on Buddha, you cannot depend on God, you cannot depend on relatives or friends, individual. My own karma is responsible for my life. And your karma is responsible for your life. Therefore, it is your duty to accumulate good karma if you want to carry on your life smoothly, peacefully, without facing the problems and disturbance, shortcoming. That is why here the Buddha says, Punyam Sukham Jivitam Rakhe. So especially when you grow old, when we are weak, then we had to recall, remember all the good deeds, all the merits, all the services that we have done. Then gives a lot of happiness. At that age, we gain happiness by thinking all the good deeds that we have done earlier. Not by thinking how we enjoy our life when we are young. That never gives happiness. Since our senses are not very active at that age, our mind also not very sound, physical body also not strong enough, we create some sort of frustration. Disappointment. When we see how others enjoy their life, we feel very sad. Because when we grow old, when the body grows old, our cravings never grow old. Remember that. Craving become younger. More alert, because cannot satisfy craving, then we increase more and more craving. So only thing that can console us at that stage is our own karma. So I have done all these good things. You have to record. Keep a good record what you have done, what you have donated, what kind of services you have rendered. Then when you are free, read. Use happiness. But don't record all the bad things you have done. That will disturb your mind. So, those days actually it was a very common practice. Especially a well-known person like kings and the ministers, the rulers, they record all the good deeds that they have done earlier. So when we grow old, then when they cannot read, then ask somebody to read all the good deeds that this person has done earlier. Then that gives happiness. When we develop happiness in our good deeds, we multiply, we increase few degrees in our merits. This is another advantage. Especially certain meritorious deeds, just like contributing to put up this kind of religious building, contributing to erect the Buddha image, or contributing for printing religious book, or helping those poor student for their education. So when you see those places, those persons, you gain wonderful happiness. Every time when you enter into this building, if you have donated even $5 or $1, or I also donated for this building, then happiness. Then the merit also increase and increase and increase. Many people do not know that. Multiply. So, that is why it is necessary to record all the good deeds. That you can multiply, increase few degrees by gaining happiness in your meritorious deeds. So after that we can develop hopes and confidence in our life, thinking that my life cannot become a miserable one hereafter. That is very important. That is what many others are doing. When people are very weak, very sick, when they are going to die, the other religious group approach them. So now, time has come for you to develop your faith and belief toward the God. The God will send you to heaven. Be happy. Develop this faith and confidence. At that moment, that man, that is a very good news. He take this as true. Because the mind is very weak. So, but here the method introduced by the Buddha, not to depend on others, not to depend on God, but to depend on our own good karma, what we have done, more reliable. Then certainty is there. It is not uncertain. Because we know the good effect, so the life can become more meaningful, more peaceful, more happy, more prosperous one. When we develop this, create this, recall all our good deeds into our mind. So when we come to a certain stage, now age, we had to reduce our mind from many of those worldly bondages and responsibilities and commitments. Then we get the chance to maintain peace, relax, then recall, remember the good deeds, meritorious deeds, services that we have done to release others' sufferings and worries and disturbances. Then if we die, when such thoughts are functioning, active in our mind, it is impossible for that person to be born as an animal, so spirit, so devil, so ghost, so hell, so unfortunate life. If not, there is another advice. It is in Mahasamaya Sutra. Mention this. When someone is going to die, if that person has not done enough meritorious deeds, and now it is too late to do some meritorious deeds, so what to do? Yekechi buddhaṁ saraṇaṁ gatāte nate gamissanti apāya pahāya manusaṁ dehaṁ devakāyaṁ paripūresanti. This you can see in Mahasamaya Sutra, in Paritta chanting book. The meaning is, when someone takes refuge in the Buddha, that means they recall the Buddha into the mind. We accommodate the Buddha in our mind at that moment. So when we maintain this, the image of the Buddha in our mind, if we die at that moment, nate dami santi apaya, it is impossible for that person to be born in hell. Because the thought, the last thought, in that last thought the Buddha was there. Then what will happen? Pahaya manusang deyang, after his or her death, devatayang paripure santi, go and join with the other devas. See? But maybe a short period, but you escape from the unfortunate state. So if rebirth take place as human beings, then develop more and more good karmas. After that, develop further and further, escape from the bad effect. So these are very good advices given by the Buddha for us to console our mind, to gain more confidence, to make up our mind, not to depend on others, but by creating such confidence in our mind, enjoy all the good deeds that we have done. That gives, here the Buddha says, that gives sukha, happiness. At that moment, this sukha, this happiness is more important than anything else in this world. Sabbasya dukkhasya sukham pahana. Then the highest sukha, greatest one, is sabbasya dukkhasya sukhang pahana. By eradicating, keeping away any kinds of physical and mental frustration, disappointment, unsatisfactoriness, pain, sufferings, if these evil forces are not disturbed the mind, at that time we experience the highest sukha, the happiness. Because the mind is free from all the evil forces. But at this moment, our minds are not free from any of these things. What we are doing actually, we control them, we suppress them by taking certain other objects into the mind. Now you are listening, you pay attention. So the mind occupied with this. So no chance of the evil forces to create mental pollution, disturbances in your mind, because you are concentrating. If you want to go further, then, as mentioned by our Reverend, develop more and more kindness, compassion, sympathy, metta, then the cruelty, anger, jealousy, grudge, ill will, all the evil forces go down and down and down and down. No chance to flare up, but remains there. the roots still remain there. For the time being, we can suppress and control them, then we feel very happy. We experience some sort of happiness by controlling them. But when we allow them to stir and blur up, those evil forces play havoc, completely ruin our mind, our body, our way of life, our activities, everything will be in chaotic condition. It depends how we handle our mind. So we should not allow our mind to act as it like. That is why knowledge and understandings are important. How to handle this mind. Although by nature, we are not good people. That is why we are trying to be good. If we are good, not necessary for us to use this effort to be good. We know we are not good. We know we have weaknesses. We know we have bad habits. But not so easy to control them. And then we try to gain more knowledge, more understanding, how to handle with them. And then the mind cannot act as it wants. The trouble is this. Many people don't like religion, especially Buddhism. Why? Buddhism asks you not to do what you like to do. That is the problem. Then you say Buddhism is not practical. You want to do so many things, but Buddhism say cannot. Then you say Buddhism is out of, not out of order, out of date. Buddhism never supports your ideas that you have created according to your selfishness, your craving, your attachment. Buddhism always advised to calm and control and disciplines and train by knowing the danger. Because you get into trouble if you allow your mind to act as it were. So religion is needed here to train that mind. Your religion means your knowledge, your understanding. Then, sutta matteyata loke is always emphasized in the Buddha's teaching. Not only actually in the Buddha's teaching, when we refer to other religions also, similar sayings we can find. Here, sukha matteyata loke, those who fulfill their duties toward their mother, matteya, mother, gain wonderful happiness. Because we can understand how our mother suffered, how much time he spent for us. At the risk of her life, she has given birth to us. We can understand how she had to suffer. So we are indebted forever, whether they are good or bad, that is immaterial. So, if we can do something to release their suffering, their worries, their sicknesses, their problems, that gives us wonderful happiness. We have done our duty towards our mother. Sukha matteyata loke. In the Buddha's language, always mother comes first, then the father. Never say father and mother. The Buddha says mother and father. Mother is more important. Mother is the one who suffers. Therefore, mother comes first. Then, just now I told you, not only Buddhism, Hinduism, Matru Devo Bhava, Pitru Devo Bhava, in Sanskrit. Regard your father and mother as your God. Not create a God, as God. Regard them, that means respect them as God. Bible also say, honor thy father and honor thy mother. It's not a new thing. And this one also, I think I have told you what Prophet Muhammad has said. That is very touching. When his daughter asked, you always talk about heaven or paradise. Can you tell me where it is? Then the Muhammad gave very meaningful answer. He said, heaven is at the feet of your father and mother. That means, when you respect your father and mother, when you fulfill your duties towards your father and mother, you will be in heaven. So every religion, again, in the Buddha's teaching, he has introduced certain important duties for us to fulfill if we really want to go to heaven. Because our main purpose is not the heaven. We have to go beyond that. But those who are keen, those who like to go to heaven, here the Buddha has shown the path, the method, what to do. But he never say, you must pray to God and worship and do some offering, then you can go to heaven. No. He started, Mata Pitti Bharang Jantu. First you had to support your mother and father. Mata Pitti Bharanja. Kule Jetha Pacharina. Then you had to respect the elders in your family, especially in your family. Your auntie, your uncle, your grandmother, grandfather, elder sister, elder brother, you had to respect them because they have more experience about life. There are many things for you to learn from them. So when you respect them, you listen to them. Then you can adjust your life to avoid certain problems and disturbances. Respect the elder. Sandhang Sakila Sambhasa. When you talk, you must know how to talk without using harsh, wicked, vulgar words which hurt others' feelings. You must know how to talk gently, politely, without hurting others' feelings. A man who came and scolded a monk by using all the vulgar words, wicked words, the monk was listening very quietly. So when he ended his scolding, the monk asked, "Are you satisfied?" Then he said, "Yes." In that case, I am also satisfied, because I supported you for you to gain that satisfaction. You can understand the reaction. If I also jump and shouted at you, you never gain that happiness, that satisfaction. So I contributed something for you to gain that happiness. Therefore, I am also happy. This is the technique, the Buddhist way, how to avoid. If you can adapt this simple thing, very simple, but can avoid very big problems and violence and enmity. Therefore, you must know how to talk, what to talk, without aggravating the situation or the anger. Sandhang sakila sambhasa. Pesuneya pahayana. Try to avoid slandering. Many people are very busybody, they cannot keep quiet. When somebody says something against another person, purpose is get a taxi and go there and tell him, you know, so-and-so scolded you using vulgar word, wicked word, and create enmity and create problems. This is the nature. They enjoy by doing that. So, we have to avoid that. If there is any possibility to settle that problem, what they have, then it will become a very good service, without aggravating the situation, without creating enmity, without making them enemies. Sandhang sakila sambhasa, vesuneya pahaya, machera. If you are stingy, if you are selfish, you cannot go to heaven. You had to contribute something. You had to donate something for the happiness and welfare of others. Think of others. So by disregarding others, simply by enjoying yourself, you cannot go to heaven. Vinaya. You must know how to maintain your discipline. There are three ways. Manasa sangvaro sadhu, sadhu vachaya sangvaro, kayena sangvaro sadhu, sadhu sabbatta sangvaro. First, we have to discipline our own mind. Just now I told you, don't allow mind to play havoc by creating all sorts of evil, wicked, stupid ideas. Handle the mind properly, train the mind, then there will be mental discipline, mental training. Vachaya sangvaro sadhu. When we talk, we must know what we talk. We must know what are the suitable words and terms and subject matters to talk. We must know to whom that we are talking, different technique, art of talking. So by knowing this, we have to talk. Otherwise, can go on talking all sort of rubbish. Create more confusion, more misunderstanding, nothing to contribute. Kayena sangvaro sadhu. When we do something, when we walk, when we eat, when we lie down, when we sit down, there must be some sort of discipline. In every action, there must be discipline. The other day I told you, amongst those 227 precepts for the monks, most of them, more than 75%, to discipline their way of life. Otherwise, they are not immoral or harmful or wicked or dangerous. Manners. So the Buddha wanted to introduce very gentle disciples who knows how to maintain their dignity and good image. I think you can remember some of those precepts I told you. When we eat, so before we bring the food nearer to our mouth, we should not open the mouth earlier. And this is one of the precepts. Again he says, alright, the food is in your mouth, then you are going to, you should not talk by keeping the food in your mouth. You must swallow, if necessary, you have to talk later. Again he says, after eating, you should not do like this. If not, you should not do like this. Of course, those who use chopstick, I think. But Indian way of eating, they say there is no taste if they don't lick. When he asks, why do you want to lick? No, otherwise no taste, you know. The Buddha, having seen all those things, says, must avoid these things. Not gentle. He wanted to introduce this kind of discipline in various ways. So discipline is the most important thing to observe the precept. Precept meaning we follow certain discipline, keeping away from those certain things are harmful, certain things are very cruel or wicked, certain things are very immoral, they are dangerous things. But the rest, all the manners, are some sort of traditional practices respected by the elders all over the world, many parts of the world. Then, I have not completed. So I had to tell you how to go to heaven, you know, all the important items. Mata petti bharan jantung kule jettha pachayanang sandhang sakila sambhasang pesuniya pahayanang machera vinaya. Discipline. Machera vinaya yutta. Satcham. What is satcham? Truthfulness. Satcha. Chaturarya satcha. Satya or satcha. Four Noble Truths. Satyam means truth. If you tell lies, you can go to heaven. You can pray and worship and do everything, but if you tell lies, you can go to heaven. Because devas never tell lies. No, only human beings. So, if you are keen to go to heaven, you have to train yourself. Here, before you go to heaven, otherwise, when you go there, you spoil the heaven also, by telling lies. Satya. The most difficult thing. The most difficult thing for human being to do. Telling the truth. Because we have some extraordinary development in our mind. Our cunningness, our hypocrisy, and cheating, bluffing, swindling. All these qualities we can find in a human mind. others do not know how to do it. Other living beings do not know how to pretend. Take for instance, if a dog is fierce, that dog never go by giving the tail near it and then suddenly come and bite. No, from the very beginning, that dog is fierce. Because dog cannot pretend. But as human beings, we can approach others with smiling face, nice sweet words and wonderful. And finally, catch. This development we can find only in human mind. This is development. Developed our mind with selfishness. Then crookedness, cunningness, cheating, bluffing, swindling, pretending. We develop all these qualities. These are the biggest problem in our human society. It is very difficult for us to trust another human being. Animals, we can trust. We know they are dangerous or not. But humans, we cannot trust. Whether they are dangerous or honest or sincere or cunning, we cannot understand. We have to associate with a long time, for a long time, to know. Even husband and wife who lived together long period, still wife cannot understand the mentality of husband, husband cannot understand the mentality of wife. Because they can pretend, never show the real mentality, the nature of the mind, always pretend. So these are the biggest problems that mind create. But when you develop our knowledge and understanding and the reality in life, then slowly, slowly we can reduce these human weaknesses. After that, kodha vibhungnara, kodha, anger, hatred, ill will, there are few words. So by keeping anger, by keeping hatred in our mind, we cannot go to heaven. We are not qualified to go to heaven. Now you can see the Buddha's method. If you really want to go to heaven, you have to cultivate all these qualities. Then, whether you have religion or not, it is immaterial. Whether you are Buddhist or Hindu or Christian, makes no difference. These are the human qualities, virtues. So these human qualities, anyone can develop even without depending on any religion. So the Buddha's way of teaching is such. Without depending on any particular religious label, we can cultivate all the good qualities to be real human beings. So if you are keen to go to heaven, you have to follow this. No shortcut. Remember. Then, sukha matteyata loke atho petteyata sukha. Now comes the father. Petteya means father. Fulfill the duty toward the mother, then toward the father. Many people say, our father has not done anything for us. They neglected us, discriminated, chased away. Then why should we respect them? Why should we support them? still he is the father. According to the teachings of the Buddha, although he is a very bad father, if you kill him, you commit a mortal sin. Because father is father. His personal character, behavior is different. Therefore, we must act wisely. Assume your father ill-treated you. Now you are doing well. Many people know that your father has ill-treated you. But if you go and help your father when he is in trouble or when he is old, everybody respects you. They say, yes, we know how the father treated him when he was young. Now he is supporting the father. He is a real gentleman. Everybody respects him. Nobody says, what a stupid son. Why do you want to go and support the father? Because he did not do anything for you. No, that should not be the attitude. Then, sukha samanyata loke. Support religious people, not only Buddhist monk, not only reverend, anybody who lead a religious life, belong to any religion. We should not think the Buddhist monks are the real religious people, others are not religious. No. We associate with them, we notice some are very gentle, very religious, very pure in their thought, in their words, in their action. They try to lead the harmless, respectable religious life. Some are, of course, cunning, selfish. So if you support, according to the Buddha, any religious man, belong to any religion, you gain happiness. When the Buddha mentioned the name of the religious people, he always mentioned the names of other religious groups also. If you want to give dana, he always say, Samana, Brahmana, Paribrajika. These are the religious people who live at that time. Samana means belong to two religions, Buddhism and Jainism, Samana. Paribrajaka, those who have renounced the worldly life to lead the pure, simple, humble life. They are called Paribrajaka. Brahmana, who perform all the religious rites and rituals and ceremonies and pray for others as religious teachers. So the Buddha always advised, if you want to offer something, give the Samana, Brahmana, Paribrajaka. See how liberal, how meaningful his religious way of life and advice given. Then, sukha samanyata loke ato brahmanyata sukha. Those who attain higher stage of sainthood, like sotapanna or sakadagami or anagami or arahanta, higher stage of achievement in their religious way of life. So you can support them, help them, also you gain the wonderful sukha or happiness. When you think, oh, today I offered dana to that religious man. He is a pure religious man who controls all his weaknesses and defilements from his mind. Try to avoid all the evil deeds. Try to cultivate his life and his mind. Try to do some service to others to lead a religious life. So by considering all these qualities, when you offer something, you develop the merits also, because of the confidence that you gain. Sukham yava jara sila. Now this is very interesting. Yava jara, until we go old. Yava jara. Silam, the precept. Sukham gives happiness. Because many people think we can observe 8 precepts and meditations when we grow old, not when we are young. The Buddha's advice is observe your precept until you grow old. Because after growing old, there is nothing for you to observe automatically. You cannot violate any of these evil things. Because you are weak, you are blind, you are deaf, you cannot do anything. So naturally, but don't think you are observing any seal at that time. You keep quiet because you cannot do. You are not observing any seal, any precept at that time. The seal, the precept you have to observe when you are young, when you are energetic, to control, to train, to discipline your senses, your greed, your lust, your temptation, then the sila is there. Because at that age there is nothing to train. Sukham yava jara sadhu. So sila, we have to observe until we grow old, still when we are active, energetic, when our senses are very keen to enjoy worldly pleasure. Then observe the precept also, to train the mind. After growing old, you can keep quiet. Naturally, you keep quiet whether you observe seal or not. Sukham yava jara sadhu. Then, sukha saddha patitthita. Now that is also important. When you develop your saddha, or your faith, your devotion, your confidence, that gives wonderful happiness, saddha. Because saddha is very important for us to develop, to establish at the beginning. There are few discourses. Saddha bijan tapo vutti kasi bharadvaja sutra. When this Brahmin was working in the paddy field, the lunch time the Buddha also visited with his begging bowl. He was standing there. Then the Brahmins called at the Buddha. We are working here the whole day and you came here without doing any work with your begging bowl. Why not you also come and do some work here, if you want to eat? Then the Buddha said, I also work. Don't think that I do not work. How do you work? Are you going to see anything with you to work? You don't know what are the things that I use to work. What are the things? Then the Buddha started. Saddha bijan tapo panya me yuganangalam hiri isa mano yottam sati me phala pachanam. So he went on mentioning all the what you call things that he used for the work. Then the first one is saddha. I use saddha to work. What is saddha? My faith my devotion, my confidence. I use sadda as bija. Bija means biji, seed. Farmers use the paddy, the seed. But I use my sadda as paddy seed. Because when the plant grows, the root goes down. When the plant grows bigger and bigger and bigger, the root support the tree, otherwise the wind attack the tree, fall down. So the root support the tree without allowing the wind to attack the tree, to fall down. In the same manner, when we develop our sadda, our faith, our devotion, our confidence, when we are going to do some work, whether religious work or any other business or married life, first we have to develop this sadda, this faith and confidence and devotion. Then it will become unshakable, not easy to collapse. The foundation is laid already. So the sadda, faith is the foundation for us to build up our religious way of life. Whatever we develop without faith, without devotion, without confidence, halfway will collapse or give up. Or you have given a prominent place for sadda. Another place, Alavaka Sutra, Alavaka, the cannibal, the Buddha wanted to train him to be a civilized man. He wanted to challenge, but he could not topple the Buddha. Then he asked question. You must answer my question, otherwise I am going to split your heart into pieces. He challenged the Buddha. The Buddha said, Nakwaham tangaso pasami sadevake loke samarke sabrahmake sasamana brahmaniya padai. The Buddha challenged. You must understand, there is nobody in this universe, among the human beings or devas or brahmas or maras, who can do that to me. Then, all of us, right? Sometimes the Buddha stands very firm. Then he said, all right, I'm going to ask this question. You have to answer, all right? Then all of us asked, Kim sudavittam purisasya sittam Kim susuchinno sukhamavati. Series of questions. So the first question, Kinsudha vittang purisasya settam. What is the highest wealth for human being? Kinsudha vittang purisasya settam. What is the highest wealth for a human being? Then the Buddha gave the answer, Saddhita vittang purisasya settam saddha. Saddha, confidence, faith is the highest wealth for a man, for a human being. Because by establishing this properly, they can carry on any work. They will never become a failure. Saddha. Another discourse. Saddhaya tarati ogham. Ogha means this whirlpool, the sansara, great ocean of sansara. We are struggling here in this sansara, in this ocean. If you want to get freed, if you want to cross this to land a safety place, we have to develop saddha, confidence. Without confidence, without sadda, without faith, we cannot cross the great ocean of samsara. saddhaya tarati yoga. Again he also introduced 7 kinds of wealth, saptarya dana. That is what young Rahula, the Buddha's son, when 7 years old, Rahula's mother, so when the Buddha was coming, he said, "That is your father," because this child has never seen the father. The very day the child was born, he renounced the world. "Every day this child asks, 'Where is my father?' All the others have father. I have no father. What happened to my father?" So this poor lady could not console this child. So when he was 7, the Buddha visited. And seeing his coming, he said, "That is your father, the lions of the human being." Then, go and ask. He got very big property, wealth. Go and ask. Then small child went to the father, the Buddha, and said, "I heard you got a very big property or wealth. Can you give this?" "Oh yes, why not? Why not? Come, I'll give." He took him to the temple and shaved his head and ordained. 7 years old small boy to give his wealth. Then the father, the Buddha's father, old man, he was so worried. Went to the Buddha and he said, "I'm very unhappy. You have done a very cruel thing, very bad thing. This, when you left the palace, this poor child was the only one who could console me. Now you have taken away that poor boy also." Scolded the Buddha. "Anyway, I request you have to give instruction to your disciples not to ordain any boy without the permission from the parent." The Buddha accepted. That is why that today we cannot ordain anybody without permission from the parents or from the guardians. Otherwise it is a mistake because of that restriction. So, then he introduced what are the 7 kinds of wealth. Saddhadhanam, Siladhanam, Hiri Ottappiyandhanam, Sutadhanam, Chagocha, Panyame Sattamang Dhanam, 7 kinds of dhana, wealth. Among those 7, Saddha, again comes first. Saddha is the highest wealth, among those 7 kinds of wealth that we have to develop. Now here it is mentioned, when you develop this Saddha in anything what we do, confidence, we gain happiness, and it will never become a failure because we use our full effort. We have already established very firmly. When you come to a religious way of life, if you do all these activities without faith and devotion and confidence, you never gain anything. Not only for the namesake or just to follow others or as your traditions, no. Develop your understanding. Then the mind becomes very firm. Then sukha saddha patitita sukho panyaya patilabho. So among all those sukhas, panya, knowledge, wisdom, understanding, realization gives wonderful happiness. So whatever we do without understanding, without knowledge, without using our common sense, we make a lot of mistakes and later we regret. Therefore knowledge, understanding is very important for us to develop. Otherwise, life will be in trouble. Always, we have to go and ask, approach others, what to do. Because we have no knowledge, we have never realized. Always depend on others. If others give wrong information, wrong advice, then we get into trouble. So not to depend on others, but to develop our understanding. Now, your purpose of your coming, in spite of all these traffic jams and disturbances, your own commitment and housework, to gain some sort of knowledge, understanding, useful for your day-to-day life, your family life, the society that you work, how to overcome certain problems and difficulties. At the same time, you are also cultivating, developing, molding your next existence. There are so many things. So you are not wasting your time, because the time that you spend here, you maintain some sort of purity in your mind. Because no time, no circumstances, environments are not the force you to create anger or jealousy or ill will or enmity or selfishness or craving, all the evil forces. The mind is pure. You try to gain something, grasp something into your mind, then slowly you can put into practice and experience good result. Then papanam akaranam sukham, last thought. If we can keep away without doing bad things, that happiness is very, very important. Papanam, papa means bad, very low, very wicked, very harmful. Akaranam means not to do. Sukham, happiness. When you abstain or keep away from bad things, induce wonderful happiness. Amongst four kinds of happiness that worldly people experience during their lifetime, according to the Buddha, the Atthi Sukha, Bhoga Sukha, Anana Sukha, Anavajya Sukha. Four. When you have something as your property, you gain happiness. That is important for you. When you enjoy your life by using what you have earned in proper manner, that also gives you happiness. When you maintain your income, your budget, properly without borrowing from others, without depending on others, that independent life also gives happiness and confidence. Then the last one is anavajya sukha. When we come to know that we have not done any harm to anybody, that sukha, that happiness is the highest. So that happiness supports us to gain confidence in our life while we are here. And after our death also, that happiness supports us. Anavajya, that is what he said. Papanam akaranam sukha. How happy we are if you can keep away from bad things. This is very, very useful sermon given by the Buddha. Okay, sir. In Australia also, you conduct these discussions and talk and very often. Your mind is there, isn't it? Where do they assemble? Or group by group in different houses. Oh, that way is better. Because when I was there, I remember I also visited few houses to have some discussions. Yeah. Okay, sharing of merit. Immina punya kampena upajaya punuttara acari upakarate mata pita piyamaman Discussion told me that from tomorrow onward he will conduct the class at 3 o'clock, 3 to 4, not 4 to 5, start earlier.